6921 Awesome. I'm here today with Spider Jack Angel. And today we are reviewing The Evil Within.
Voila.
So let's start off with you, Spider Jack Angel. What did you think of The Evil Within?
Well, for starters, let me just say that this is a very good, refreshing horror video game. I mean, this game is done by the creator of Resident Evil, and Resident Evil, back when it was on the PlayStation 1, was a very good survival horror video game. You basically played as one of two individuals, and you basically wandered around this mansion in the first video game, and ammo was very limited in the first video game as well, and basically had to choose between running away from zombies or, you know, confronted them. And with The Evil Within, it's very much a return to that formula. It's no longer a, like, an action horror video game like Resident Evil became. It's more of a survivor horror video game. Like, this is, if I was going to sum it up, it's the equivalent of what would happen if Saw, Freddy Krueger, Resident Evil, and Silent Hill all made it together and had one big, gigantic offspring.
And an automation.
It is that, like, bizarre, screwed up. I mean, there's parts in this video game that will just make you go, like, what the fuck? Like, I mean, you didn't play one of those parts, the part where basically you had to lobotomize the brain.
Oh, yeah.
You know? Or basically stick the needle inside the brain to basically, you know, see which part of the brain you have to put pressure to open up the door. I mean, just, like, stuff like that is just, like, completely out there. And you just go, like, what?
I love the opening of the game, how the game just gets you, like, right in it. Like, the opening of the game of the PlayStation 4 version, because that's the version we're reviewing, not the PC or other versions. But as far as the PlayStation 4 version, I mean, the opening of the game, I felt that I felt like I was playing like a movie, because, like, I was like, oh my god, this is the game. I thought this was a video, because, like, I didn't know it was the game.
The opening of the game is incredible. You play as this character by the name of Sebastian, wanted to make sure here, before I say the name. And basically, he goes to investigate this incident at this hospital. And basically, he gets there with his detectives, and he just looks at the surveillance camera, and he sees this figure that just brutally murders everybody, and then turns around. That figure basically appears and sticks a needle right into his eye, and he's going, like, holy crap. And I'll be the first to say this. And I know when me and you were talking while we were playing the game, I died quite a bit at that first part, because I didn't know that I was supposed to steal the key from the individual after you got off the meat hook. So, you know, I kept on basically figuring it out. I was, like, trying to say, what do I do here? You know, I didn't want to look up on the internet because I wanted to figure it out for myself. And I died, like, 5-6 times over and over. And I was going, like, holy crap. And by the time I finished the game, it did tell me how many times I die, 137 times.
Yeah, the opening of the game is very Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Like,
well, if you watch the video of the making of the game, the maker of the game actually said he, you know, borrowed a little bit from Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Like, Texas Chainsaw Massacre inspired certain aspects of the game.
Was it the remake or the original, you think?
I believe the original.
Oh, okay. I could also see kind of like things that they did from the remake also.
But oh, there are things that they have borrowed from other.
Yeah.
You know, let's just throw this out there. Jackie R. Haley plays the voice of the villain in this game, and the villain of the game is very Freddy Krueger like.
And that's ironic because he is the new Freddy, so that.
And on top of that, there's just like a little backstory. Not gonna ruin it for anybody, but there's a little backstory of an individual, and it's very, very reminiscent of something that happened in one of the recent Freddy movies. I'm not gonna. I know you know what I'm talking about, but yeah, and you know, throughout the game's very challenging.
That's a really good way to put it, though. That the game is like whoever designed the game, you know, the developer, is clearly a fan of horror films, and he wanted it to be like Nightmare on Elm Street, Texas Chainsaw Massacre. He was kind of like, you know what I mean? He wanted it to
feel like... Yeah, he did say that, I believe it was either Dawn of the Dead or, Night of the Living Dead was his inspiration, little inspiration as well. Because he was asked, you know, what was his inspiration for horror video games.
And, yeah.
But however, you know, there's just like moments in this game that is just like very, very nightmarish, very, very frustrating at times. Because there are moments in the game where it is very frustrating. I mean, the chainsaw guy, not the first one, but the one that you run into, I believe it's on the third chapter. Like, he's freaking frustrated as hell. I fucking died, like, probably 10 times with that dude. And there are, like, just moments in the game where, basically, you're running low on ammo, and you're just basically praying that you could basically kill, you know, the boss or the enemy that you have to face. I mean, this game at times gives you the big middle finger like this.
Well, like, I want to point...
Well, I'm talking about with the middle fingers, like, I'm talking about the times where they confine you in one area and you have to face an enemy with very little ammo, and you're just going like, what the fuck here? But however, you know, the game, while being frustrating, never really reaches that point where you're like, okay, I'm done with this game.
And it's like you gotta make sure that you got the right weapons, because if you do not, you are gonna like
get raped.
Yeah, basically, you have to have like the bow and arrow. If you do not have the bow and arrow, you're gonna go through hell.
The bow and arrow is. Well, not bow. Yeah. The crossbow.
Yeah, the crossbow.
The crossbow is a good weapon.
You gotta have the crossbow. I'm
using the shotgun just as much. And, you know,
I think the handgun sucks. I just want to say the handgun.
Oh, no, the handgun's really good. If you upgrade it.
I have been upgrading it, but, like, I gotta say, like, my favorite is the shotgun. And the bow and arrow, those are my favorite.
The handgun is really good in the game, and you just gotta upgrade it. And
I like the sniper.
You know, to each his own. My favorite would be the shotgun, and then also the crossbow is good for planting traps, because you can, like, shoot little mines, basically, little explosives, basically, down on the ground and wait for enemies. You also get this little, like, flame thing later on where basically you can shoot it down and basically plant a trap. And that comes in really useful, because the fact that when you're facing hordes of enemies, you know, and they have, like, weapons and are shooting at you, it's pretty much you have to basically figure out what is the one weapon that you can deal the most damage and basically take out as many enemies as you can. And usually, depending on the enemy, you basically should use the crossbow with a, you know, flame, because the fact that you can just shoot that down, a little flame thing shoots up, and basically fire goes to the right, to the middle, to the left. It's a very good weapon to use.
Oh, and killing people with your bare hands, it is incredibly hard, unless you upgrade that.
us, let me just, I know you bought the digital copy.
Yeah.
But just take a look at this artwork.
Okay.
Let me take this out. Look at that.
Nice.
I mean, this is very, very, like, old school horror type, you know, poster in a way. Because
yeah.
You can see this as, like, a, if this was a, you know, movie, you could see this right here as like, a poster for the movie.
It would make an awesome movie. I hope that they do make it into a movie.
I hope they do make it into a movie, but they kind of cast really good actors, and not so much go in the Resident Evil route, like the movies. I mean, I like the Resident Evil movies. Don't get me wrong here. I thoroughly enjoyed all the Resident Evil movies.
Because they're already making The Last of Us into a movie, so they could make this one into a movie if they wanted to.
Oh, yeah, they can make The Evil Within into a movie, but...
Yeah.
Now, to refrain from spoilers in terms of the ending of the game, but I will say this. When you get to the end of the game, I was not 100% surprised by what it was because of the fact that I kind of thought it was going to be something like it was, but at the same time, they did do some things that were very creative, and on top of that, the ending does leave it room for a sequel, but the final boss battle at the end of the game, not going to ruin anything, but the final boss battle at the end of the game is probably one of the most creative / craziest boss battles that I've actually played in a video game recently. I mean, it's just, like, insanely crazy and just very creative. I would say it's probably tops pretty much every boss battle in all the Resident Evil games, and that's pretty much saying something. Well, maybe not so much Revelations, which was for the 3DS, but and eventually all consoles now. But, however, it is very crazy, insane, and creative. It's just, like, really, really awesome. And there are parts in this game where, basically, you're just like, okay, you know, how much more insane are we going to get here?
Yeah.
And they basically just say, you want more insane? We're going to toss a giant effing spider at you. Just going, like, why?
Two different gamers. I'm a casual gamer. Spider Jack Angel is a hardcore gamer.
Oh, yeah.
And as a casual gamer, I would say that we played, like, we had basically, you know, two points of perspective on this game. Like, for you, this game was not incredibly difficult for you, but for me at the beginning it was really difficult, so I wasn't 100% sold on it, but once I got into the story, that's when I became sold on this game, basically. You know what
well,
I mean?
Well, let's be fair, I died 137 times by the game's completion, so once I got to chapter 3, I found it incredibly difficult.
Yeah.
And then there were some chapters that were a little bit more difficult than others, and then there were others that were, you know, rather simple.
Yeah, but
I would probably say what really was probably the most difficult stuff further on in the game, it mostly dealt when Jackie or Haley's character would show up, and basically you'd have to run and hide from her, so one touch, she would kill you.
Oh, yeah, and also another really difficult thing for me was finding all the damn freaking keys in the game, but those little statues, they're hidden in, like, special places. Sometimes you can't find them, and sometimes you can. I know you had difficulty. I found about, like, 4 or 5, I think.
I only found one.
You only found one. See, that they're really hidden in the game. Like, you really got to look.
Yeah, I kind of want to know what's in all those, you know, corpse locks thing.
Yeah,
like,
I mean,
I kind of want to know what's all.
It's basically like syringes, like money,
ammunition too.
Yeah, I mean, all kinds of goodies in there. And like, if you get those keys,
you know what's in the what's in the morgue there.
Yeah. It really helps you when you get those keys, you know.
Yeah, I'd probably say the other thing that is, you know, really kind of frustrating is, like, the part where they, I know I said this before, but the part where you are locked in an area and basically you have to fight, like, one or two enemies and both of them are rather strong and you're just, oh my God, just let me live through this, just let me live through this. Probably the boss battle that I had the most toughest thing with, it would probably have to be the boss with the dog in the game, and it's like a mixture between a mutated dog and a wolf, but the fact that what was very frustrating about that boss is the fact that he had no order in which he basically moved. I mean, he basically had to run around, and he would, like, kind of go, like, zigzag and, like,
Is that the one where you have to get the guy's glasses? Is that the one?
Yeah,
yeah. Oh, don't you just hate it when the guy's like, I forgot,
I'm just like, really, why do I have to be the fucker that goes back and get your fucking glasses?
Jesus. He's like, it's not that I need them. It's just that I want to feel normal.
It's like, dude, you freaking are a dumbass. You get captured because you basically go across a bridge to take out a horde of like 3-4 zombie thing, only to trip over a freaking bomb, and then get captured, rely on your partner to save your ass, so as basically you're gonna get your head chopped off.
We saved that guy's ass so many times in that game, my God.
You basically don't, you know, that guy doesn't care, you know, what happens. He's just like,
He's just like, I'm gonna kill myself now. I got a gun in my head. You saved me.
But,
yeah.
You know, with that being said, The Evil Within is a very fun game.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's frustrating, but it's very fun. Me personally, I would give the game a solid 10 out of 10. I don't give 10 out of 10s a whole lot. You know, very rarely give 10 out of 10s, but this game just was a 10 out of 10 for me because, one, it was good. Mm-hmm. Two, it was challenging. Three, it was a good throwback to survival horror at its finest.
Yeah.
Four, you know, the characters. Five, there were certain elements in this game that basically borrowed from movies that I really like Resident Evil, Saw, Nightmare on Elm Street, Silent Hill, you know, video game, movie.
PlayStation 4 game I've seen so far. Definitely check out this game because it's really, really good.
Yeah, I mean, like, the parts that are really incredible.
Yeah.
Is, like, where it basically where put you into this, like, peaceful environment, you know, where basically you say, oh, this is kind of peaceful, and then it just shifts into, like, this nightmare from hell.
Oh, yeah, I love that little, like, Alice in Wonderland kind of, like, oh, it's all nice, and then, God, it's hell, oh, no.
And then, like, the lighting, the fact that, you know, a couple of scenes will be black and white, and then basically shift to basically being in color. It's just, like, wow.
Yeah, I mean, the graphics, like, they're just astounding on the PlayStation 4, I gotta say, like, as far as, you know, what they pushed in this game, like, it's amazing. Mm-hmm. I can't wait to see what, you know,
I will say this, the one thing that this game did bring over from another video game that I just was like, oh, why did you have to bring this over? And it was the freaking water monster from freaking Resistance 2. I mean, I freaking hated that water monster in Resistance 2, you know?
Yeah.
And in this game, they one up it because they're just like, you know, what we're going to do, we're going to show you from the monster's perspective, if you're basically in the water and you have to swim to a specific location, we'll show from the monster's perspective, like, he's a shark coming after you. And, like, it's, you know, pretty interesting how you die for that monster because basically, you know, Sebastian would look around and all of a sudden the monster would basically dive from out of the water and basically snatch you, much like the Piranha did at the end of Piranha 3D.
Yeah.
You know, just be like... I mean, you know, this is like parts like that that are really, really good. And, you know, for all of you that are, you know, our subscribers, Epicore fans, both me and Danny have been posting videos of our gameplay for Epicore fans. So yeah. Please check it out. I'm sure, you know, most of us probably have captured some of the most finest moments in it. You know,
yeah.
And plus, you know, after I complete the game for a second time, I might do a run through, basically, little special thing for Epicore fans page where I just basically let everything kill me and just see what is the many different ways you can die horribly in this game.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm Spider Jack Angel. Thank you all for watching.
Have a great night.
Yeah.